apologize in advance. The eating you're about to see will not be pretty. And if you have young children, this would be a good time for them to leave the room.
Today we are learning English with Garfield. This movie came out a few years ago, and I'm super excited to teach you guys some nice vocabulary and pronunciation today. But before we get started, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and bell down below, because every week there are new videos here on the channel to help you understand your favorite movies and TV series, without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. So hit the subscribe button in order not to miss a single new video. And Xenia, actually we have some news here about movies to talk about today. Apparently there is a new Garfield film coming out next year. Have you heard of that?
I didn't think so. Oh, it's that fluffy, clumpy cat?
Lazy cat.
Lazy cat? Yeah.
That's the one. The cat that loves lasagnas, I believe. I saw this news recently because apparently there is an older Garfield movie that came out in 2004 or 5. And Bill Murray, the actor, actually voiced Garfield then. But now, in this new Garfield film that is coming out next year, in 2024, Chris Pratt is voicing Garfield. And apparently, fans were not very happy with Chris Pratt's work or performance as Garfield. They prefer Bill Murray. That's what I read about. But in any case, I think it would be cool for us to watch a little clip from the older Garfield film with Bill Murray and explain some nice vocabulary and pronunciation to our viewers today.
Let's watch it.
Leave me alone. I'm not kidding, Yodel Odie. Pop a worm pill and hit the road. I'm busy. You want to play? Fine. You can be my new astronaut. Go jump in the pail, and we'll shoot you into outer space. Come on, it's real simple. Here, I'll even throw your ball in there. Follow the ball and jump in the pail. Come on, Odie. Just like this. Come on over here and just jump right into the pail and help me. Come on. No, just in here like this. Uh-oh, don't touch that.
I think I saw this movie when it came out, but it's been such a long time that I actually don't remember, but I think I saw it. Nice expression here that I like to see was leave me alone. You can say that to somebody who is bothering you and who is, you know, giving you a hard time, because hey, leave me alone. Like, get out of here.
Exactly, yeah. That's funny. He was trying to show the dog how smart he was or something, talking about this outer space, yeah. He said, like, get into this pail, yeah? And the pail is another word for bucket, right?
And we can also see the pail falling on top of Garfield later in the clip, right? I think I heard, I'm not kidding. What does that mean, Sin, when you say, hey, I'm not kidding?
It means, like, I'm serious, not joking, right?
Another great expression here is pop a pill. I love that. Pop a pill. A pill is a medication that you take. So to pop a pill is to take a pill or to take some sort of medication. But this is a more informal, casual, fun way to say take a pill. How would you explain the pronunciation here in this phrase? This is a nice one. Pop a pill.
Pop a pill. A lot of connected speech here, right? So first, we should always pay attention to the aspiration in the sound p in English. Yeah, so it's pop a pill. With aspiration, like when you hold a letter, you know, a sheet of paper, think that breath of air, then there is, between the words pop and pill, there is the schwa sound, right? Pop, pop, pop a pill.
That's it, yeah. It sounds funny to me, pop a pill, pop a pill.
Yeah.
I think I heard in that clip also the phrase hit the road. When you tell somebody, hey, hit the road, it's like leave. Get out of here.
That was interesting.
Road, right?
I don't think I've ever heard it used that way, because I knew hit the road is like, for example, when you, together with your friends or together with your family, start a journey or go somewhere, you say, let's hit the road.
That is true. That's another maybe possible context there, yeah? All right, we hit the road at 7 a.m.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
To go to the beach, for example.
So it's interesting to know this in other usage of this phrase, right? Kendro, just leave me alone. Yeah.
I guess it's because I was thinking of that classic song from Ray Charles, I think. Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more.
Oh,
you
know? No more, yeah.
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back.
But speaking of pronunciation, we have here also, you wanna play? You wanna play? So the you here is a yeah, yeah, yeah. You wanna? You wanna? And then the one, two becomes a wanna. You wanna play? You wanna play?
And it's all pronounced like one word very quickly. Yeah, you wanna play? There is another short phrase which also pronounced like, you know, together very quickly. So the phrase come on, like encouraging you to do something faster, it's pronounced like really fast. Come on, come on. We only hear this first sound, ko. Sometimes may be followed by, again, schwa sound, ko, come on, right? Come on, come on. But sometimes it's so short that it only, like, we only leave the K sound.
Are you enjoying this lesson? Great. But did you know that this lesson is just a short clip from the whole lesson? If you want to access the entire lesson, make sure to download the Real Life English app. The full thing is there. But also, on the app, you can do many other great things. For example, for the week's episode, we give you a digital transcript, so you can actually listen and read along every single word and expression that we use here on the podcast. Also, we give you a few flashcards per episode so that you can improve your vocabulary much faster. The app uses cutting-edge technology based on spaced repetition that helps you really memorize those words and expressions that you see us using here on the conversations on the podcast. And finally, with the app, you can also connect with another English learner anywhere in the world to have a short conversation in English. Isn't that awesome? So make sure you download it. The link is going to be here in the description of this video, also in the show notes. Or you can simply go to your favorite app store, let's say Google Play Store, Apple App Store, search for Real Life English and download the app from there. You know, I'm having a great time with this Garfield clip. What do you say we watch a little bit more of that?
Okay, I'm only up for watching more movies.
Let's do it then.
Well, well, well. I've got you now, fat cat.
Hey, Luca. Is that a new chain you're wearing, fella? Looks good on you. You look great. You've been working out?
I've been waiting years for this.
Would that be regular years or dog years?
What the? Get away from me, Pipsqueak.
Luca, this is Odie. Odie, Luca. Luca, do me a favor and eat him for me, would you please?
Garfield, are you all right?
I think so. Luca's about to have Odie for lunch.
If it wasn't for Odie, you'd be Luca's chew toy.
Yeah, he saved your life.
Odie's a hero!
Why, because I wasn't ripped to shreds? No, Odie's an imbecile until further notice.
You know, I think at the beginning here, we hear one of the dogs going, well, well. You know, I actually picture myself saying this, well, well. You know, when I see my son doing something wrong or doing something that he's not supposed to be doing. Like, he tells me he's doing his homework in his room, but then when I open the door, he's actually playing video games, you know, playing with his phone. And I go like, well, well.
It's just like in reprimand, like, right? You're reprimanding him.
Yeah, I see that well, well being used in that context, you know, like, huh, what do we have here,
There's a nice connect speech or just like this pattern. Looks good on ya, not looks good on you. So we shorten this you to ya.
I didn't even hear the it. Yeah, it looks good on you. Just looks good on
point.
You. This is actually very common to happen, right? Native speakers do that all the time. Some more advanced speakers do that also. We tend to omit the pronoun sometimes, like in this case, instead of it looks good, I say looks good. Or it sounds good, I say sounds good. And even auxiliary verbs too sometimes, you know? I can say, for example, instead of did you like the movie, I could just say, hey, you like the movie?
He also calls him fella, right? Mm. The cat calls the dog fella. Could you explain that, Chaga? What is fella?
It's an informal way, especially in American English, I would say, to refer to friend or buddy. Hey, fellas, how you doing? Hey, guys. Hey, buddies.
I think it sounds very American, right? Hey, fella.
I believe so, yeah. Maybe in British English, they would say mate, maybe.
Hey, mate.
Hey, mate. That's a possibility.
Perfect.
I think bloke, too.
Oh,
dude,
right.
Guy.
Dude. And do you remember how the dog called the cat?
I think it was Pipsqueak.
Pipsqueak. I don't know this word.
You can use that word to refer to a short person or short creature in this case, yeah? Because the dog was really big and the cat is small. And it's more of a offensive way to call somebody who is short like that. Imagine you are maybe reprimanding your little brother. Hey, get out of here.
You pipsqueak. Pipsqueak.
Especially if you are a short person. If somebody uses that word on you, you know what the person means.
You know. Chado, there was also an interesting grammar point in this clip. Seems like there was a conditional sentence there. I think those two cats who came up to Garfield said something like, if it wasn't for Odie, you would be Lucas' toy or something, right? So he said this sentence, imagining the situation, what could have happened if the dog wasn't there, right? So that's the second conditional sentence, and we use where, the past simple in the first part and the if part of the sentence, and we use would plus verb in the second part of the sentence. The only thing I have doubt about, I would always correct my students if they used was in the if part. Traditional grammar book would tell you that it should be where, if it were not for Audie, yeah, or it, if it weren't Audie.
Yeah, you were not wrong, actually, because that's the correct way the structure goes. So you use were for everything. That's what traditional grammar says. If I were, if he were, if she were, if it were. And so in this case, the correct way would be if you weren't for Audie. But in a formal, casual conversation, like in this case, we're watching a movie, it's common for native speakers to go, if it wasn't, if it was, if I was. So it's important to remember that. It is possible to use it, but it sounds more informal. You might see that in everyday conversation, in movies, series, or even in music. You see, speaking English well goes way beyond just learning grammar rules. Yeah, you gotta know these little nuances like context, tone. A great phrase here that I heard was ripped to shreds. When something's ripped, imagine you tear it apart like in an aggressive way. Like if I rip my shirt off now, yeah, I'm not gonna do that, of course, right? But like, you know, like that. And to shred is like to small pieces. I think that Garfield was referring to the big dog and how the big dog didn't rip him to shreds, pretty much kill him, yeah? And turn him into small pieces. And very nice word here, imbecile. What is an imbecile?
It's only good in terms of pronunciation. In fact, the word is not good at all, right? Imbecile, yeah, is another way to call a person dumb or stupid.
Leave me alone. I'm not kidding, Yodel Odie. Pop a worm pill and hit the road. I'm busy. You want to play? Fine. You can be my new astronaut. Go jump in the pail and we'll shoot you into outer space. Come on, it's real simple. Here, I'll even throw your ball in there. Follow the ball and jump in the pail. Come on, Odie. Just like this. Come on over here and just jump right into the pail and help me. Come on. No, just in here like this. Uh-oh, don't touch that. Oh, no. Houston, we have a problem.
I've got you now, fat cat.
Hey, Luca. Is that a new chain you're wearing, fella? Looks good on you. You look great. You've been working out?
I've been waiting years for this.
Would that be regular years or dog years?
What the? Get away from me, pipsqueak!
Luca, this is Odie. Odie, Luca. Luca, do me a favor and eat him for me, would you please?
Garfield, are you all right?
I think so. Luca's about to have Odie for lunch.
If it wasn't for Odie, you'd be Luca's chew toy.
Yeah, he saved your life.
Odie's a hero!
Why, because I wasn't ripped to shreds? No, Odie's an imbecile until further notice.
Global citizens, thank you very much for learning with us. But you should know that this was just a short clip from the full lesson. The full lesson is available on the Real Life English app, so come on. Download the app and continue listening there. You're gonna learn even more cool stuff. See you soon.